Come join us in the Optics Lab at the Library of Congress.
We're going to show you how science helps us see art in a new light.
This equipment uses different types of light of the electromagnetic spectrum to help us characterize and understand what the materials of our collections are made out of so we can preserve them for future generations. So my favorite project that I've worked on in the 14 years I've been here is the Herblock political cartoon collection. He was a prolific cartoonist his entire life. We have 50,000 rough sketches and drawings, but also the raw materials that he used to make the drawings themselves. Some of these pens even came right off of his desk. We're able to make our own sample sheets of the known pens that he used so that we can identify the exact ones that he made with his cartoons.
And why would that be important?
That way, if any of them happen to be light sensitive or prone to degradation, we can inform the curator to house them in a different way or exhibit.
So even these different shades of red might react differently to light?
Correct. So even though all of these inks look black, they're made of different chemical compositions. And so being able to identify that with our different instruments will actually show us that they have different spectral properties. So on this cartoon in particular, you can see how some of the inks have already started to turn brown and degrade. Being able to characterize exactly which pens those are with our samples enables us to better identify those that should be in priority for digitization to make sure that his cartoons as is are still available in the future. So now we're going to do some multi-spectral imaging, which is a digital photography method that uses light beyond just the visible in the ultraviolet and the infrared. Even though we can't see in those spectrums, the camera can pick up a lot of really useful information there. So the camera took pictures at each of those individual wavelengths. And as we click through the thumbnails, you can start to see how those different chemically different inks start to respond differently. Some of them start to become more transparent and others get darker. So here we've done some processing of the cartoon. So on this image, everything that's blue is the same ink. Everything that's green is the same ink. And you can even see in the bright magenta there where he was using whiteout to make some of his corrections.
Students and teachers are interested in this. Then at home, they can get a black light. They can explore a prism.
Students could take their own images and put them in a photo editor and start playing around with the different RGB channels as well.
It's really cool to see how science can help preserve our collections and keep them safe for generations to come.
When people think of traditional artist materials, they're thinking of pigments that have been around since cave paintings. But those are pretty stable. They've been around for hundreds of years. But more modern materials like these on the Herblock cartoons are made so rapidly and change so fast that we're really not sure what the longevity is. So instruments like this help us keep up with the rapidly changing inks and pigments of modern times.